Welcome back. In this video, we are going to solve example 8.5 that is taken from chapter number 8, Combined Loading, and book name is Mechanics of Material by R.C. Hibbler, 9th edition. So statement is, the solid rod shown in figure 8-6A has a radius of 0.75 inch. If it is subjected to the force of 500 pound, determine the state of stress at point A. So you can see this is the rod, clear, that is acted upon by 500 pound load at point B in the direction of Y. This is Z axis and this is X axis. So due to this 500 pound load, you have to determine the state of stress at point A. So let's start with the solution. So first step is that we will section this rod at C. So you will have two portion. One is this one and second one is this one. So I will take the second portion and we will draw the free body diagram, so it will be like this. Let me draw it first. This rod will be like this. Okay, you have to draw it correctly. So this is the rod, this is at end, this end. So here you have 500 pound load that is acting, 500 pound force load. This is Y axis, clear. This is your point A, where the vertical axis is Z axis, clear. And this axis in the direction of this, it is X axis. Okay, the distance, this distance is taken as 14 inch. I will write it 14 inch, and distance from A till the center of this will be equal to 10 inch. Okay, so I have drawn roughly free body diagram 10 inch. Now you can see at point A, when you cut it, so this 500 pound force is in Y direction, so there will be a normal force at the center of this, so that will be equal to, let this load will be equal to P. Clear, this is the normal force. There will be a shear force in direction of Z, clear, and we will take this as V. And you can see that this force 500 pound and perpendicular distance is this, is producing counterclockwise movement about Z. So in order to balance it, we will have a clockwise movement as well. So I will put here about Z axis, we will be having moment M, clear. So we'll find this P, M and V by using equation of equilibrium. So first equation of equilibrium is that sum of all forces along X direction must be equal to zero, and force toward this X direction, which is like this, sorry, this is taken as positive. So as we can see that there is a no force along any X direction, so it will be not used. The second equation that we will be using is sum of all forces along Y direction must be equal to zero, and force toward right side is taken as positive. So P, which is acting opposite to Y direction, plus 500 is acting towards Y direction, their sum must be equal to zero. So it means that P is equal to 500 pounds. Okay, now we'll apply the third equation, that is equal to sum of all forces along Z direction must be equal to zero, and upward force is taken as positive. So along Z direction we have shear force V, and there is no other vertical force, so it means that shear force is equal to zero. And another equation by which we will find this M is that sum of all moment about Z axis must be equal to zero, taking the counterclockwise moment as positive. So this moment M, which is clockwise, so I will write minus M, and this force multiplied by perpendicular distance is 14 is producing counterclockwise movement about Z axis, so it will be positive. So I will write plus 500 multiplied by 14 is equal to zero. So from here, this movement about Z axis will be equal to 7000 pounds multiplied by inch. Now you have all these forces and movement. So you can see that if you take this section at this point, so we have taken the portion 2. So if I draw the first portion will be like this one. So let me draw it a little bigger. So the first portion will be like this. Clear? Where you have this diameter like this. Clear? And this is the portion. So at point C, you can see at when you take at point 2, so this this load in the first portion at this section will be toward this direction. So I can write this P at this portion will be like this. This is P, which is equal to 500 pounds. And you can see the movement in section 2 is counterclockwise. So here it will be in clockwise direction. So I will draw, this is your x-axis, this is your z-axis, and this is your y-axis. So about this z-axis, this will be in counterclockwise. Okay, this will be in counterclockwise direction. Okay, now you can see that this will be your point A. I will specify it by using pink color. So you can see due to this normal force will produce normal stress, which will be equal to sigma, and that is equal to P divided by cross-sectional area. So this will be a cross-sectional area. So P is 500 pound, and the radius of this rod is given as 0.75 inch. So its area is equal to pi r square. So pi multiplied by r is 0.75 square. So when you solve this, you will get normal stress will be equal to 283 psi. R in kilo, psi we can write it 0.283 ksi. Ksi means kilo pound per square inch. Okay. So this is the normal stress due to normal force. Now we can see that due to this movement about z-axis, this is the movement. I can write it. So this, due to this movement, this beam will like bend like, this rod will bend like this. It will bend like this. Clear? So this point A will be, this layer will be in tension, and this layer will be in compression. So point A will be in tension. So I can write bending moment will produce bending stresses. And you can see that this normal load is producing the normal stress in the y direction. So I can write it, this will be in y direction, and this will be normal force. Now this bending stress, due to this bending moment, there will be bending stress in the y direction. And we can also write it that sigma due to bending moment will be bending stress at in y direction. And you can see that this load normal force will produce stress at this cross section. So this will be at point A. So I can write stress at point A in the direction of y, and this will be normal stress. So stress at point A due to bending stress in the direction of y will be equal to m into c divided by I, where m is the bending moment, c is distance from the centroid till outer, which is, you can see, this will be the radius. Clear? And I is the second moment of inertia of this circular cross section. So put the value, m is 7000, C is 0.750, and I for circular cross section, it is equal to pi by 4 r power 4. So r c power 4. So pi by 4 multiply by 0.75 power 4. So when you solve this, you will get bending stress at point A in the direction of y will become equal to 21.126 psi. or you can see bending stress at point A in the direction of Y is 21.13 KSI. Okay, so this is not 21.126, this is 21.126 PSI. So in KSI it will be 21.13 KSI. Now you have both normal stress and bending stress. So if I draw it, so this combination, we can also write it like this. For example, if you are taking for normal load, so I will draw the stress distribution due to normal force. So it will be like this. So due to normal stress, the stress distribution will be on this section will be like this. All this will be in tension. Okay. On this cross section, all will be in tension. So we can also say that this is your, for example, this is its axis, this is your point A. So this stress is due to normal force, that is 5,500 pound, not 5,500 pound, and this stress is 0.283 KSI. Also, if you take bending moment separately and draw the free body diagram, so this is again the cross section of this circular rod. Clear? This is your axis, z axis, and this is your y axis, y, z, and x axis. And this is your point A. So you can see that this bending stresses will be maximum at this outer surface, and this will be at outer surface. It will be like this. Okay, you can see that this will be this. Let me choose another color, this one. Will be like this. This is the mid, so this will be like this. This stresses will be like this, and about this z axis, this will be the stress will be zero at point A. It will be maximum. So we can also say that this is the bending. This is bending stress due to bending moment of 7,000. Pounds into inch, and this bending stress is 21.13 KSI. And if you want to draw the state of stress at point A, clear, you have to add them both. So state of stress at point A in the direction of Y is equal to, due to this normal force which is in positive Y direction, 0.8283 KSI, plus this bending stress which is in y direction, 21.13 KSI. So when you add them, so you will get the bending stress at point A in the direction of y will become equal to 21.4 KSI. Clear? And if you want to draw the state of element in the direct in at point A, so you can see this was your z axis, this is your x axis, and this is your y axis. So we can say at y axis, this will be sigma A in the direction of y, 21.4 KSI, and on other face it will be opposite to this because this is in tension. So this was all about this problem example 8.5. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Thank you for watching.